Hey there, movie fans. Scott Moviemantz here with the Moviemantz Q&A. Now, the film is I Care A Lot. Had its world premiere at the Toronto International Film Festival in September of 2020, and it is streaming now on Netflix. And if you do not see this movie, you are missing out. What an entertaining and fun, razor-sharp, dark comedy written and directed by J Blakeson, in which Academy Award nominee Rosamund Pike from Gone Girl, she plays a court-appointed conservator who is an opportunist. She preys upon the very rich elderly, and then she proceeds to steal their money. This is I Care A Lot.
Good morning, Miss Peterson. I'm sorry to disturb you so early. The court has ruled that you require assistance in taking care of yourself.
I'm fine.
I'm afraid it's not up to you to decide. The court has appointed me to be your legal guardian.
What?
You have to come with me. And remember, I'm here to help.
My name is Marla Grayson.
I'm just someone who cares.
Marla Grayson, you've had amazing success. What's your secret?
There is no secret, Peter.
She forces them into the home, auctions off their house,
and uses the proceeds to pay herself.
Because caring is my job.
Bitch! I will grab your dick and balls, and I will rip them clean off.
I don't lose. I won't lose. I'm never letting you go.
You know how much I love this movie.
Yeah, I do, Scott. You've been a great champion, and thank you.
Well, absolutely my pleasure. It's been so great just to see the work you've been choosing lately, these last few years, Private War, Radioactive, and now I Care A Lot. What was it about this story, the screenplay of Marla Grayson that just made you go, oh my God, this is awesome?
Well, I mean, the first opening voiceover where, you know, she starts by saying, look at you, you think you're good people. You're not good people. There's such thing as good people. And you think, it sort of takes the air out of you and you think, wow. And then you go into this courtroom and you've got this woman who's, you know, seems to be an upstanding member of the community. She takes care of the elderly. She's, you know, in passionate debate with the son of a woman under her care saying, look, you can't care for her by doing what she wants. You have to do what she needs. And you think, okay. And then suddenly the judge's gavel goes down and you just see this look behind her eyes and you think, oh, what am I dealing with here? And then you realize that it's all a sham. You know, she's taking these people to the cleaners. She's preying on the most vulnerable sector of society. And you think, how does this happen? And then you realize that it can happen because the system is set up for it to happen. It's set up for people like Marla to win. And I was just completely riveted. And I thought, well, this is electrifying. This is terrible and funny and entertaining and dark and awful and yet delicious. And I mean, I was sold.
Well, honestly, Rosamund, as you know, we talked elsewhere about this. I watched this movie twice in one day back in September with Toronto. I never, ever do that. And I just was thinking about it more recently, just when I watched it again. What movies inspired you to find Marla? Like what other characters made you go, oh, that's a good one. I got to channel that.
Well, I mean, I've always, several times in my life, I've gone back to To Die For with Nicole Kidman, which I think is an amazing performance and an amazing film. And, you know, there's something so steely and ambitious and the sort of whole, I think it's these women characters that you get who have an element of performance to their natures. I find it quite unsettling, you know, when there's a performance that dupes people convincingly. It's some of the, especially when they play on some traditional traits of you know, sympathetic, you know, female characteristics, and then they use them and manipulate them, and you realize that they're only pretending them. You know, in Marla's case, you know, she's very good at convincing that she's trustworthy and honorable and caring and nurturing, and she's none of those things. She has no moral compunction whatsoever. Mm-hmm. And I think, you know, Nicole's character in To Die For was able to display that too and seem to be nurturing people and drawing them out and a kind of, you know, a leader and a beacon, and then everything turns. You know, it's the power. It's a terrible power that some people have to manipulate and control. And I'm very interested in that, and horrified by it. And then you know, Jay and I both love The Last Seduction with Linda Fiorentina, because, you know, she is really unpleasant in that film, and yet, undeniably, you kind of can't deny that she's fun to watch. And we're trying to always find that line, you know, how far can we push this character, Marla, and still make her fun to watch? And I hope we did find that line. I think we did.
Oh, I absolutely think you did. She is so much fun to watch. I can't wait to watch it again when it drops on Netflix on February 19th. And I just got to say congratulations on your Golden Globe nomination. So well deserved.
That was a great day, Scott. Thank you. It, you know, whatever happens now, it's just a little big. I feel very proud of that, you know, for this movie and the fact that it'll hopefully make people pay attention to it, and they'll watch it on Netflix when it drops, and they might discover it and they wouldn't otherwise. So, you know, I'm very, very grateful to the HFPA, who, as we know, you know, watch everything judiciously, and, all one cares about really making movies is that people watch them. That's what we're asking for, isn't it? We want people to watch them. It's not about the prizes, it's about the audiences, and I just want this to find an audience, so.
Well, it will, because I'm going to do everything in my power, because you know what, Rosamund? I care a lot.
Thank you, Scott.
Thank you, Ros. Great to see you. And thank you for joining me here on the Moviemantz Q&A. Please give this video a like. Please share it with other movie fans, especially so you can get the word out about I Care A Lot. Again, it is streaming on Netflix. You've got to see it. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel, Scott Mantz. I would really appreciate it. And until the next episode of the Moviemantz Q&A, here's looking at you, kid.